State Representative Jon Santiago is our guest this morning. Let's go on the record. His run for mayor of Boston came up short, but he remains a force on Beacon Hill. What he sees with Election Day fast approaching and the vital link between the State House and City Hall. Let's go on the record.
From WCVB Channel 5, the inside word from Washington to Beacon Hill. Today's newsmakers are going on the record.
Welcome to OTR on this last day in October. I'm Ed Harding, along with News Center 5's political reporter, Janet Wu. It's great to have you with us. We are joined by State Representative Jon Santiago this morning. Let's run through the vitals. He's a Democrat. He's representing the 9th Suffolk District. He's a resident of the South End. He's also an emergency room doctor at Boston Medical Center, captain of the Army Reserve. He holds degrees from the University of Texas, the University of Washington, and Yale. But more importantly than all of that, you're going to be a dad when?
That's right. First week of March. My wife
first week
is five
of March.
Months.
There you go.
Very mega good. Congratulations.
Mega congratulations. Well, great to have you with us.
Vitals. I like that. That was really cute. Okay, let's dive into it. Polls say there's 30 points between the two mayoral candidates. You're not a pollster, but you are on the ground. You know where the votes are. Do you think Wu really has that sizable of a lead?
Well, listen, I think Michelle has run an incredibly disciplined campaign from the get-go. She's been the front runner. I think she will win the election. I don't know if by 30 points. No doubt that things will close, the gap will begin to close as we approach Election Day, but I think all points, all signs indicate that Michelle Wu will be the next mayor of Boston.
The airwaves are flooded with both super PACs and ads from the two candidates. Do you think that's going to make a difference in the end, or do you think everything that happened prior to this will have a big
impact?
Listen,
if you look at the most recent polling, I think 8% are undecided. Mm-hmm. You know, folks have made up the decision. These candidates have traversed the entire city, talking to people in every neighborhood. I think people are ready to vote, and whether it's Annissa or whether it's Michelle, I think come sometime Tuesday, we'll find out who will be the next mayor of Boston.
You have spent time on the front line. So Annissa Sabi George, like Janet was just saying, is just hitting Michelle Wu pretty hard in the debates and in the TV ads as these final weeks and her super PACs as well. So is that a winning strategy to hit hard and keep hitting?
Well, there's no doubt that Anissa's been an impressive debater. She's grown tremendously as a candidate, but I think people have made up their mind. I mean, again, the recent polling would suggest that 8% of folks are undecided. And whether, you know, the debate, whether you saw it, whether you were there for Michelle mm-hmm. or for Anissa, mm-hmm. I think people made their decision, they've drawn their conclusions, and they're ready to vote on Tuesday.
So you can't move the, what about a lower turnout? You know, they were in the preliminary 110,000. Yeah. Does that, if that's reflected in the general, how does that affect the race?
Well, we'll see. You know, there was a lower turnout to be expected in the primary. My guess is that turnout will grow in the general election. I don't think it'll grow that much. I think turnout will be overall pretty low.
So Mass and Cass is at the center of this campaign. As someone who lives and works just blocks from there, is there any real difference between Wu and Essaibi George's views on this? Do you see much of a difference between them?
Well, I think they've both expressed a desire to work with the community, work with public health officials, the medical community as well. I think Mass and Cass is a crisis of epic proportion. I think we need leadership immediately from day one. My concern is that moving forward, regardless of who the mayor is that we will lose the energy that we've gained over the past couple months. I mean, you can't read the papers or watch the news without mm-hmm. talking about Mass and Cass. Mm-hmm. Rightly so. People are suffering on the streets. People need a plan, and I'm looking forward to supporting a mayor who's going to do something effectively and boldly to address the crisis that's happening on Mass and Cass right now.
You're a doctor that actually treats many of these people that live, you know, or live and are in that area. Does either Michelle Wu or Annissa Essaibi George have a better plan, in your view, for dealing with all of this?
Well, I think the big difference between the two, from what I can tell in the debates and in the press, is that one supports a Long Island bridge, the other one doesn't, right? I think we all can agree that Long Island needs to be a part of the solution, right? And whether it's a bridge or whether it's a ferry, it remains to be seen. I mean, what we do need is a public health approach. We cannot criminalize opioid use disorder. Mm-hmm. We need to move forward in a very bold way. And I'm looking to support a mayor who's going to do that, who's going to stand up for the community, who's going to stand up for my patients and get the job done. This is an incredibly complicated problem. This is the nexus of public health, substance use, and homelessness. And each one of those issues is complex. Now, when you put the three together, it makes it exponentially more complicated. And so we're going to need some leadership on this issue from day one.
That's where I wanted to go. How bad is it? I mean, honestly, we just showed some images from the street, and obviously yeah. perhaps they're difficult to look at. But how bad is it? How deep is it? How difficult is it?
It is a tragedy. You know, people are suffering on the streets. Again, people that are homeless, people who have been experiencing trauma for decades. And people are preying on them, right? It's not just an issue of homelessness, mental health, and substance use. there are significant public safety issues happening right now. There are people preying on these folks. There are sexual trafficking. There are several fires. There are health issues. I mean, it needs to be addressed with a certain level of boldness mm-hmm. and immediacy that, you know, needs to happen from day one.
And which leads us into the next one. Is Sheriff Steve Tompkins' plan of forced incarceration for those at Massancast with outstanding criminal charges, yeah. is that the right move?
I don't think that's Steve Tompkins' plan. I think okay. there's been a disconnect with what has been reported in the media and with the conversations I'm having with Sheriff Tompkins and the like. Look, Sheriff Tompkins has proposed a plan that is not too dissimilar to what's already happening in this jail. Listen, has a legislator and has a physician. You know, I've pushed efforts to increase substance use services across jails in the Commonwealth, mm-hmm. right? Sheriff Tompkins has a program right now. It's called OASIS, right? I'll tell you what Sheriff Tompkins' program is not. It is not a Section 35 involuntary commitment. It is not an Operation Clean Sweep. Sheriff Tompkins does not have the power to charge or prosecute folks. He does not have the power to arrest people, right? Mm-hmm. He's just providing services for people who are interacting with the criminal justice system, and I support that.
We could talk about this all morning, but I want to ask you about Annissa Essaibi, George's husband, his reported problems with the city as a developer affecting her campaign. Has it affected her campaign? Do you think it's going to lose her votes?
I think it's concerning. You know, I can't comment. I've met him briefly at a social event. He seems like a nice guy. I can tell you that from conversations I've had with folks that they've expressed some concern about it. But outside of that, I can't really speak to it too much.
But do you think it's hurting her on the ground as far as votes are concerned?
Well, I think the press hasn't been very favorable to it, and I think it'd definitely be hurtful. I think she would prefer it would to have mm-hmm. not been covered, mm-hmm. but it is what it is.
If she was clear in the last debate, for example, on Monday night here at Channel 5, that when asked about even the item of the tax return, she says she's released her tax returns. Husbands know, yeah. you know, whatever.
Yeah, well, I think so the focus of the campaigns, both for Michelle and for Annissa, should be on the candidates, their respective platforms, their ideas, their solutions, and let that be the debate.
Mm-hmm. If you had been mayor and you were in a similar situation, what would you have done? And I understand they're both hypotheticals. Yeah. In other words, if you were running for mayor or mayor and your wife was involved in the same type of business, what would
you do? I think I would have been as transparent as possible. I think I would have released my tax information as well as my wife's information as well.
Should she have done that?
Well, perhaps. I mean, it's up to her. I mean, you'll have to ask her how she feels about it. And it looks like, you know, we had a debate last week and she declined. Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.